things in life is to be different. It's not easy to, and it's not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you try to, you know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what Make Your Own Way stands for. Your way. Everybody's is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block, you might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be, but everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Li Ning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small. Now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and competent in any arena.
Make Your Own Way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, kind of follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, without youth. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man. Just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life. You know, so I've been there before and I get it.
Things in life is to be different. It's not easy to step out and do something that the next person is not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you try to, you know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what Make Your Own Way stands for. Your way. Everybody's is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block, you might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be, but everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Li Ning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small. Now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and competent in any arena. They're coming.
Make your own way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, not a follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, with our youth. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man, just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life. So I've been there before and I get it.
By far his best game of the season. Chris Rosales, 20 points for him. He led everybody. There is O attacking the rim. So back and forth it went, but the final score, 84-69. Singapore would come away with the easy win, 84-69. It wasn't the best game the Slingers have played, but defensively showing their pedigree, shutting down Saigon when they needed to, limiting them to 69 points. And that 69 points is just about where they have held the average teams this year. So we had some interviews with some coaches before the game, the Saigon coach, or the Bangkok City coach, and Coach Neo from Singapore.
Well prepared in the first quarter of beginning of the game, because they come in with confidence after they beat High Tech. But we start off the game well, but after the 8 minutes, I mean, we play good defense, but we get ourselves a good lead and end up we become very sloppy in defense. That's why get them into the game. And as a team, we don't really execute in offense. It's more on individual, which is I'm not pretty happy with that.
Well, first of all, you're right. Like, we really need to win this game, and not only this game but the remaining game. As of the changes, what I can say is definitely there's not gonna be much change with the play system. It's just giving the big man some more advices and guidance, and you know, like defensive wise, we're not able to go and accomplish that like last game when we lost with Singapore. But this time we definitely told the guys already. To be aware of what and what. And let's see what happens today.
Well, I mean, stick to our game plan. I think we need to shut down the two big. But last games, Lam got a good game. I think he scored 30 against us. We need to really work on our defense, individual and as a team. So I think we have to take care of our own business rather than them. As a team, okay, we run the floor and we play good defense. I think we should be capable to get this win.
Number five. Perspectives from both of our coaches. Game time just around the corner here. The Slingers getting their ovation from the hometown crowd. Another nice looking crowd for the Slingers. And from all of us, we want to wish you a very happy Lunar New Year. Gongsi Fai Chai from all of us. And it hasn't seemed to stop some of the enthusiastic fans for coming in and cheering on the high-flying Singapore Slingers. We're being introduced right now first place in the league, as we said, with a record of 13-2, going against last year's champion, High Tech Bangkok City, sitting at 11-4. Well, High Tech Bangkok City probably has the most dynamic starting four in the league. You talk about Chris Charles, Steve Thomas, pedigree down low. Add in Tyler Lamb, who filled it up against the Slingers the last game. 30 points he had. Freddie Goldstein also from the top, giving the High Tech team power and finesse from inside and out. And for sure, Singapore are going to have their hands full tonight against this very proud High Tech Bangkok City team. They know it's important for them. They can't afford to fall yet another game off the pace. If they were to lose tonight, that would give them five games lost with 11 wins, and very, very difficult task indeed to catch the Slingers with only four games to go. Singapore not without their stars, and there's Chris Rosales right there, the little guard from the Philippines, first year player for Singapore. 20 points last week against Saigon. Had such a good game that he was elected the ABL Player of the Week. Mix him up with Xavier Alexander, the slasher, the central number three man. He can do it all, dish it off, shoot from outside, and attack the rim. He has been very, very solid for the Slingers all year. Also, Justin Howard leading the team in scoring, 21.1 points a game, 16.3 rebounds a game as well. Singapore very, very rounded inside and out. And don't forget the local boys, Wu Wong and Desmond Oh, who have been filling it up prolifically from the outside the last three games especially. Wong, remember, serving the two-game suspension for an altercation in Malaysia. He is back and in full steam right now. So just about ready to get it underway here at the OCBC Arena. Fasten your seatbelts, because everything to play for today. Singapore desperately wants this game. They can solidify their position at the top of the league here in Bangkok, chasing Singapore. If they can win this game, then they would only trail the Slingers by one game with four to play. Anything can happen, as we have seen time and time again here in the league. Singapore in white, High Tech Bangkok City in green, and crowd still filing in here. As we look at the starting lineup for the Slingers, same lineup they've gone with lately. Desmond Oh, Chris Rosales, Xavier Alexander, Delvin Goh, and Justin Howard. On the other side of the ball, Wadapong. He was limited in his play last time. Lamb, Goldstein, Charles, and Thomas. It's a very, very balanced team. Very, very evenly matched, both these teams. Easily the best two defensive teams in the league. Bangkok, a slightly more prolific when it comes to scoring. But Singapore, very good indeed at forcing turnovers. And look out when they get into the open court. They are very good indeed. Both these teams take care of the ball pretty well. One and two in forcing turnovers, and one and two in taking care of the ball. So both these teams pretty much mirror images of themselves. If you're going to give an edge, perhaps down low to Bangkok with the addition of Thomas plus Charles. Chris Charles had a great game last time against Singapore. Remember, he fouled out with about 7 or 8 minutes to go. A lot of people think that was the difference in the game, losing Charles. Bangkok lost a big part of their offense and defense underneath the board. Howard able to attack the rim with at will. So they'll probably want to stay out of foul trouble. They don't want a repeat of that situation, losing either Thomas or Charles to fouls. And at the same time, Howard, who has played just about every minute of every game, is going to have his hands full trying to keep that pair off of the rim. Xavier Alexander, remember also, he can fill in at the number four when need be, but he is most effective when he's facing the basket. We said a slasher, he can cut to the basket, he can dish off. Last game, for instance, against Saigon, he had 6 assists to go with his 17 points. And he has been on fire the last 3 or 4 games. But they do need their local boys to help from outside. And that is exactly what Wu and Wong have been doing since they have been together in the lineup. And Desmond Oh, as we said before, had his perhaps best game offensively last game when he scored 9 points. Also a very good defender. We know that Singapore has a lot of their national team on this squad, and Alexander and Justin Howard have done a very, very good job of leadership this year. Throw in the sleeper, Chris Rosales, and it's a solid team for Singapore going against a very, very dynamic team, the high-tech Bangkok City. So, a couple of seconds away. We'll see how this shakes out tonight. I think a lot of the teams around the league would be tuning in to this game as well, hoping for a Bangkok victory, because that would saddle Singapore with its third loss and tighten things up considerably, especially if you are a member of Westport, Malaysia. Now, they will be here, by the way, on the 14th of February, Westport, Malaysia, who are now virtually tied with Bangkok in third place. But one thing Malaysia has to worry about, they are going to have to travel to Bangkok for two games. So three very, very tough games that they are going to have to tend with going down the stretch. And all three of those games, from the perspective of Westport, Malaysia, are away. So Chris Charles is going to jump it off against Justin Howard. Singapore, as we said, in the white jersey, Bangkok in the green, and we are officially underway here. Ball controlled by Rosales in the backcourt. Singapore attacking from right to left. Alexander with Lam out on him. Gets the ball down, and Howard can hit from there, but didn't. Oh, my goodness. A tip. It looked like Thomas, but they're going to give it to Delvin Goh. Talk about improved players for Singapore. Delvin Goh, little skip pass inside. Charles with the exquisite footwork gets it to go. Off the glass, up and in. Charles had 16 the last game here. Alexander with the ball. Scoots it out to Rosales. Rosales will cut through. Now off the dribble. Gets it off to Goh, who can't handle it. So first turnover of the game. Charles alertly picks it up. Gets the ball back to number zero, Wodapong, and offensive board. And this is where we expect Bangkok to be very good in stepping on the line. Last time these two teams met, Bangkok dominated the offensive board. Let's take a look at it again. Underneath, you can see Thomas shuffling his feet. So a traveling call. Alexander up high, gives the ball off to Goh. Alexander scoops off to the right, bounce pass inside. Thought about it, good recovery. Goh now, nowhere to go. Rosales outside, going around the screen. Long shot off bounce, way off the mark. Thomas, lead pass to Charles, and a foul, and that would have counted had it gone. Rosales had no option except a foul, so Charles will go to the line for a pair. 2-2 early on, 8:29 to go here in the first quarter. Chuck Schreiner with you, hoping you're enjoying the action from right here at the OCBC Arena. As we said, Singapore 13-2, leading the league. Bangkok at 11-4, second, misses the first. Both these teams normally pretty good free throw shooters by ABL standards, right around 60-62%. Charles averaging over 16 rebounds a game. Misses them both. Howard rips the board. Back to Rosales. Left-hand dribble across the mid-stripe. Quickly down and setting up. Bangkok sort of in a helping man-to-man and almost stripped as Alexander finds a hole. Gets it back to Goh. Bounce pass to Rosales. Rosales with the jumper from the left-hand side. In and out it goes. Charles outlet pass to Wodapong. Wodapong knifing between two defenders, and a foul, and that'll go on Desmond Oh. So Wodapong finding a little space in between two defenders. Watch it again. Alert pass on the outlet. There is Lam. In fact, not Wodapong. Tyler Lam. Remember, he filled it up for 30 points against the Slingers last game. Lam, a product of Long Beach State and also UCLA. Drains the first one. Lam does have some Thailand roots. As he hits both. He was commenting when he came to Thailand in an article I was reading. It was amazing how the people flocked to him once they found out that he had a Thai mother. Howard down low. The little turn, yes! Off the glass and in. Howard becoming very proficient at that little baby hook. Going glass that time. He was isolated a little bit further away from the basket. Charles with the ball now. Bounce pass inside to Lamb. Has it changed by Alexander, and out of bounds it goes. Last touch by Bangkok. Great defensive play by the X-Man. Screening out the shooter. Charles looked up and Alexander was right there. Rosales again now. Lamb working against him. Gets the ball over to Desmond O. Howard being covered by Stephen Thomas down on the low blocks. Oh, looking for somebody. Now gets it down to Howard, looking for movement. Go with it, attacks the basket inside. Loses it out of bounds. So second turnover for Singapore. Go involved with both of those. Watch it again. Delvin really nowhere to go. Blind pass, well covered by Chris Charles. Here comes Goldstein. He had 16 against the Slingers, knocked away momentarily by Desmond O. Now coming off of that, little hesitation, rip pass in the middle and off the hands of Charles. Good idea by Goldstein, but alert play by Justin Howard. Desmond will wait for numbers. Go out top. Looking inside now, Alexander to Rosales, inside to Howard again. Thomas working on him. Little jab step, little fall away jumper, and traveling call on Howard. So uncharacteristically, Singapore with three turnovers in the first 3.5 minutes. No way to start a game. Lucky to be tied at four. Goldstein gets it across a half-court stripe. Woodapong looking for movement, asking for the screen. Instead gives it off to Charles. Now Charles throwing the screen for Goldstein. Down low for Thomas. Thomas, yes, circumnavigating the key there. Nice move. Off the right foot, up and left, up with the left hand. So 6-4, high-tech Bangkok City, off the dribble and getting lost in traffic. What is that? A foul will go on Charles, I believe. That's a first on Chris Charles. Remember, he fouled out of the last game. You can see he's come over, but a little bit too late on the weak side help. Very close call, could have gone either way, and checking out the game will be Go. Checking in will be Wong Wei Long. And after that two-game suspension for the altercation he had in Malaysia, he has rounded into the player that he was before. Very streaky shooter, but he helps you in a lot of ways. X-Man at the line, first of two, back rims that. Alexander, from time to time, has some problems with the free throws, but sure delivered last week. Excellent game for Alexander against the Heat. Misses them both, so both these teams a little bit off color from the line to start it off. Back comes Goldstein. Wong working on him. Thomas, quick pass down low. Nice job by Woodapong getting away from Rosales. So 6-4 now. Check that, 8-4 in favor of Bangkok. Wong. Off to Alexander. Wong will flash through. Wide open look for the X-Man from Freesville. Well short, following his own shot, trying to chase it down, but Lamb right there. Right hand, double team, but getting away from it. High arcing shot off the rim is no good. By the way, staying in the game, actually. Rosales bringing it back is Delvin Go. So my mistake. O checked out, so two big men in the game now trying to cope with the size of Bangkok. Rosales off to Wong. Long three. Oh, yes. Wong Wei Long. Easy as you please, filling it up. 8-7 just like that, and that's what he's capable of doing. He can change the complexion of the game. Look at this. Quick look to the right side and then squaring it up. And off the mark it goes. Go with the rebound, gets it ahead to Wong again. So one and out for Bangkok at the 5 minute mark. Wong again, coming all the way out is Howard. Alexander will pop up, Howard will give the screen inside. Little stutter step from Xavier, looking for somebody to move inside. Howard all alone will fill it up. Got to put a hand in his face. He is excellent from anywhere around that area, facing up to the basket. He can beat you in so many ways. Check it out again. Well, we'll come back to it later. So Goldstein with the ball, 9-8 Singapore. Charles big step and go comes out to meet him, and he fouls. I believe that will send Woodipong to the line. Dasom Woodipong, he didn't get a lot of PT last time. He started the game, but then quickly came out. So a timeout on the court as we watch it again. Woodipong off the dribble. And you can see Go not moving his feet and picking up the foul. So a timeout with the score. Slingers 9, High Tech 8. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, OCBC Arena. Singapore Slingers 9, High Tech Bangkok City 8. Game that we expect to be close all the way. Chuck Schreiner with you, hoping you're enjoying the action. 4:15 to go here in the first quarter as we have the two premier teams in the league, at least for this year at this point. Two best defensive teams, and offensively perhaps Bangkok with a slight edge. Singapore actually doing a very good job of keeping Bangkok off the board. So at the line now, Woodipong for two. The captain of the team misses the first one, and the jinx is still on for both of these teams. The basket seemingly has a lid on it. Woodipong has been player of the week this year, back in October. So 9-9, we are tied up. Back comes Wong. Xavier running with him. Rosales turning the corner on Goldstein. Still Rosales. Nowhere to go now. He's going to have to get it back outside. Cross-court pass to Wong. He fires it up well short. Partially blocked, I believe. Woodipong off the break. Xavier with him, and the shot is off the mark. Nice defense there by Alexander to deny Woodipong on the break. Holding his ground, knowing exactly where to stop. Alexander behind the screen of Howard will take that long three and can't hit it to go. Charles with the outlet pass, knocked away. Again, Alexander alert on defense, saves Singapore again. Great hands on the last two possessions on defense. Xavier getting back, first man back down the court. Now Thomas going against Go. Can't get it to Go, and nice play defensively by Go. Now Rosales in the open court. Stops, turns the corner. Now Wong, first step is good, inside to Go. Go on the reverse, no, he'll kick it back out. Long three is good. Wong Wei Yong. Great recognition by Delvin Go to kick it back out. Wong, no hesitation at all, fills it. And just like that, Singapore up by three. Thomas, inside pass, and Charles fills it up. So 12-11, Chris Charles. Nice footwork by him. He is so smooth inside. Xavier, inside to Howard. Quick pass over to Delvin Go, and puts the ball on the floor and again loses it. So Delvin Go twice getting isolated under his own basket. Really didn't need to put the ball on the floor at all. Should have taken the strong move up to the hole, but he didn't. Woodipong looking for movement. Hits Charles. Charles Howard working on him inside. Mismatching there, and Thomas is going to win that against Go every time, and I wonder how long they're going to keep going with Delvin Go. 2:10 to go. 13-12 now, High Tech regaining the lead. Alexander off the dribble. Now left hand turns, has his shot changed. Nice defense. I think that was Woodapong. Charles gives it off to Goldstein, who will reset. Long three is launched. Back rim. Charles mistimes his jump. Alexander, three on two. Still Alexander. Hesitation inside and a foul. And that'll send the X-man to the line for a pair. Well, Alexander again leading the break for Singapore. He has been everywhere, leading the break, coming back to help on defense on the opposition break, just basically making a nuisance of himself. Delvin Goh going out. You can see that coming. Checking in will be Wu. Wu, who for three games had the hot hand. Off game for him last game. But he was player of the week 3 weeks ago for Singapore. Had 5 points last week in that winning effort over Saigon. 84-69, remember, that was on Sunday. Alexander misses his third free throw. Supposed to have two shots on that. A couple of players forgot that item. 13-12. Bangkok in the lead. It's been as close as we thought it would be from start to where we are right now. 1:37 to go here in the first quarter. One of two, and again, the fourth tie already in the game. Charles to inbound it. Back to Charles. He can dribble the ball. Outside it goes to Goldstein. He'll hold it up. Charles looking for separation inside. He comes up to the high post, delivers the screen. Alexander, ball's up in the air. Charles alertly picks it up, slices through two defenders, up against the glass and in. 15-13, once again, Bangkok with the lead. Rosales now coming back, screened by Howard. Off the screen, back to Howard. He can hit from there, and does. Soft hands for a big man, 6'10", but sometimes he plays a lot shorter than that if given space. So the game tied at 15, wide open. Look for number 13, who's just entered the game, underneath to Charles. Check that. That is Stephen Thomas, and he's fouled from behind. Nice pass there by Gogar. Thomas will go the line to try and complete the three-point play. In fact, that was number 13, Piapong Perdon. As we look at it again, there's Perdon in between two defenders, and there's the foul by Howard on the hand. So two-point lead for Bangkok. Under a minute to go here in the first quarter. Looking more like a chess match early on. Singapore tried to go with Goh as much as they could, but Goh three turnovers and really gets mismatched down low against either Thomas or Charles, so not an option for very long. So Thomas doing his job, getting three. Rosales off to Howard, coming out and getting it is Wong around one screen. He'll go to his left hand, falls on the floor, alertly gives it off to Alexander. Wide open look, but whoa, won't shoot it. Rosales, stutter step, the shot, yes! Chris Rosales, nice hang time by the Filipino. 1 point game, 24.3 to go. 2 seconds between shot clock and game clock. One touch pass, Lamb circumnavigating the middle. Charles pulls down the rebound, out he comes. Throws off the rim, Charles with another one, yes! What hustle by Chris Charles. 3 point lead again, four on the clock. Alexander denied by Charles. 1 second to go, the shot is up and off. So good quarter for High Tech Bangkok City. At the end of one stanza, Bangkok 20, Singapore 17.
Yeah.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, off the first quarter timeout. 2017 Bangkok. Chris Charles show, much like it was last time. He has 8 points already, 8 points and five boards, three offensive boards for Chris. But he has been the story, at least in the first quarter. Backup jumper by Lamb is in. Biggest lead of the game now from Bangkok, 22-17. Rosales quickly getting the ball down. Four turnovers in the first quarter for Singapore, three for Bangkok. Singapore 7 of 15 from the floor. Ball rotated to the right and knocked out by Stephen Thomas. Bangkok 8 of 15 for 53%. 4 of 7 for the line, 1 of 4 from the line for Singapore. So, mirror of last game. Since the offensive rebounds being owned by Bangkok, good defense, long shot by Rosales, rattles it home. See if that's a three, it is. So that's one way to get back in the game. 2 point lead now. Rosales, we said player of the week last week, 5 points for him early on. Thomas against Howard, faces up. Overload on that left side, long three is gonna be off the mark. Rosales right there. Ill-advised shot there by Lamb. Alexander back to Rosales, working that left side. Charles with Howard working on him inside. Shot is changed. Charles saves it, but right back to Alexander, alertly at the baseline to pick it off and put it in. 22 apiece. Xavier Alexander, what a job he is doing. Charles dribbling the ball, almost has his pocket picked and almost walks. Lamb now, things settle down, gets the ball inside to Thomas, who works on Howard. Physical move, up and in and count it. And the foul will go on Howard. That will be two on Justin. Check that, that will be one on him. They're going to call it on Alexander, actually. Alexander now one foul. Stephen Thomas playing like a man possessed. The bigs are lighting it up tonight for Bangkok. There's your three-point play. So 25-22. Bangkok doing it inside. Charles and Thomas show. Wong. Outside shooting and alert play by Alexander, keeping Singapore in contact. Flacking across is Alexander. He looks in for cutters, nothing there. Seven on the shot clock. Charles on the baseline and he loses it out of bounds. It'll be Singapore ball, but the shot clock down to four with 7:55 to go here in the second quarter. So a little catch and shoot action. Inside to Rosales, backed up to the basket, turns and fires. He's off the mark, rebound contested for. Outlet pass, coming to Lamb. Howard back, reverse, can't get it to fall. Nice job by Howard, cutting off the angle. Now quickly, Alexander off the dribble, up and in. Nice job by the Slingers in transition. Mismatch between the quickness of Alexander and Charles didn't come out and get him. So 25-24, Goldstein off the dribble, will back up three, no good. Foul is gonna go on Howard as he wraps up Stephen Thomas. And that'll be the first foul on Justin. Justin with 6 points thus far, Rosales with five, Alexander with five for the Slingers, and also Wong with those pair of threes with six. So balanced scoring. And he said for Bangkok, it's just been almost all Charles and Thomas. Thomas quickly inside. A foul and count it. Wong right there. See Charles turn around. Who was there but Wong? Wong tries to strip him. Charles has the strength. Now watch this. He'll turn the corner, get that step on Alexander. There's Wong who commits the foul. So 3 point lead now for Bangkok. The chance to make it four here in the early portion of the second quarter. The game living up to expectations early. There's your three-point play. So 28-24. Woo, been the invisible man so far for Singapore. Cuts up. Gets the ball off to Rosales. Downstairs again. Cross-court pass. Alexander given space. Wide open look. Rosales will fire it up. Good!
Chris Rosales!
Give him three on that. 1-point lead in Singapore. Again, matching it up from the outside. The ball out of bounds. Great defense by Wong, and Singapore will get it back. Well, I think number 12, Bandit Lockman, was surprised to see Wong right there in his grill as soon as he inbounded the ball. Good ball rotation by Singapore. There's the screen. Rosales rolling off of that. Nice job. Wide open look for Alexander. The shot's going to be well short. Outlet pass once again to Lamb this time. Nice hustle by Singapore to get back on D. Rosales working on Lamb. Up pops Goldstein. Now Charles Alexander working on him. Now the double team comes. Rosales. Very quick first step by number 12. Atoning for his error. Lockham fills it up. 3-point lead now for Bangkok. 30-27. Alexander now. Wu up top. Rosales working hard trying to get free. They switch. Howard with the shot, yes. So Singapore from the perimeter getting it done again. The reluctance of Bangkok to come out on the shooter. They are paying the price. Timeout by Bangkok. 30-29 High Tech at the break. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. 30-29 High Tech, Bangkok City over the Slingers with 6:03 to go here in the second quarter. No doubt the timeout called by Bangkok. They're going to have to remedy the situation where they do not come outside and put a hand in the Slinger shooter's face. That's creating all sorts of problems for Bangkok. It means they're going to have to open up their zone a little bit. Now, that could be good news for the Slingers. You want to give guys like Alexander room in which to come off the ball and dribble penetrate Chris Rosales as well. That could create another whole set of problems for Bangkok. But right now, nothing to choose between these two teams. Bangkok and Green attacking from left to right. Again, working on that left side. Wide open look for number 12. Filling it up again. Bandit Lockman. So 32-29. Wong rotating to left back over to Howard. Wu throwing the screen, but they let it go to Alexander inside. Wild looking shot there. Good defense. Could not get around Chris Charles. And quickly back come Bangkok inside. Nice defense there by Rosales. And up and in by Charles. Finding the lane and getting away to the basket. 34-29, matching the biggest lead of the game for Bangkok. At the 5:15 mark, Wong off the dribble, take that long three, yes! Oh my goodness! Long way long, his third triple of the game. And down on the ground is Wu, who seems to be shaken up. 34-32 now, High Tech. Let's see if Wu is gonna have to come out of the game. Yes, he will. A little bit woozy, was knocked to the floor. Desmond O checking in the game. Desmond, remember last week, had the big 9-point game. And look at Wong. There you can see Wu going to the ground, kicked by a shoe for his effort. Good camera work, guys. So 34-32, housekeepers come out, clean up a little bit of the moisture on the floor. Well, we expected a tight game, and No team has had a lead more than five, and that was Bangkok on two separate occasions. Singapore is led by one only. So we'll see if they elect to go back downstairs. Once again, Thomas popping up. He will throw the screen, and it's a cruncher on Wong. Wide open look from that left side is going to be off the mark. Rebound fought for, and a foul will go on Hu. It's going to go against Singapore, I think. Crowd doesn't like that. I think that's going to go on Howard. If it is, that'll be two on him. Let's watch it again. I'll watch Howard. Oh, my goodness. Could have gone either way, couldn't it? Inside, rolling to the basket, off the mark. Charles fighting for the rebound, up and in. Chris Charles getting possession once again. 4-point lead for Bangkok. Alexander applying the screen. Around him going Wong. Wong back the other way. Alexander looking to attack the basket. Thought about it. The ball is loose, and who else picks it up but Chris Charles? What a game he's having. Down the left side is Goldstein. Goldstein off the dribble. Inside look to Lamb. Weak side help coming over. Off the mark it is, and a foul. So Bangkok starting to assert themselves, attacking the rim. And that's something we thought that Singapore would have a hard time against. Look at him turning the corner. The foul, I believe, is on Wong. So Wong, foul number one for him. And at the line will be Lamb. A chance now for Bangkok to add to that lead. They lead by four. They've led by as many as five. Rebounding extremely important. Second chance opportunities in the case of Charles. Second, third, and even fourth chance opportunities for him. He has revenge on his mind. Remember, Bangkok at this point last game was in control, similar to what they are doing now, but Charles fouling out, and after that it was all Singapore as Howard dominant down low in that last quarter. Lamb filling it up. Back matching the highest lead of the game is Bangkok. Bangkok really not showing much outside. They've been dumping the ball inside to either Thomas or Charles, and that has worked like a charm. Also running the court very well, and Lamb hits both shots. So Wong coming back at the 4-11 mark. Alexander being pressed into service. He's played the number 2, 3, and 4 tonight. Rosales, he's got a couple of threes as well. Wong, and the ball picked off. Lamb in the open court, turning his defender inside out. Off, follow is, who else? Chris Charles. 40-32, Bangkok in command here. And Charles dominant here in the first half. Rosales across the line. Howard almost loses it and does, but a foul. See who that's going to go against. I believe number 30, Nakhon Janasuk. Getting ready to check back in. Delvin Goh, as Singapore is going to have to do something to increase the odds that they can get rebounds underneath the basket. It's either make the three or one and out. There's the foul there by Janasuk. There'll be one on him. So Chris Charles with 17 first half points thus far. His credit, only one foul. 6 points for Lamb. So Singapore, no answer for Charles. We'll see how Singapore wishes to play this. It's really not the points so much, but it's just keeping him off the offensive boards. He has hurt Singapore time and time again, much like he did last game. You can tell the extra intensity that Bangkok is bringing here to the OCBC Arena. They know the importance of this game. Remember, they are at 11-4. One more loss would give them five with four games to play. They would be trailing Singapore by three full games. Singapore has been excellent at home and seemingly always finding a way to come back, but you sort of get the feeling that tonight, just no answer for Chris Charles. Remember, Steve Thomas they've got to contend with as well. And Thomas also playing excellent today. He has 10 points. So you look at Charles and Thomas together, 27 of High Tech Bangkok City's 40 points. So off the timeout, Singapore will have the ball. Alexander to inbound it off the curl. Comes Wong. Wong to Alexander around the screen. Has to kick it back outside again. The long two is going to be no good, and down goes Thomas. Howard with an offensive board. Gives it off to Go. Skip pass cross court. Inside it goes, and a foul. And that, had that gone, it would have counted. Nice move. Passing the ball around. Getting the ball to Alexander. Let's see who the foul goes on. It goes on Thomas. That will be on Charles. That's two on Charles. And that's something that Bear's looking into as we matriculate through this game. Missing the first shot is Alexander, who has not hit his free throws tonight. Charles now with two fouls. Bangkok with that big 8-point lead. Oh, with two, Thomas gets the rebound and nothing doing for Singapore. Goldstein off the dribble. Pass inside to Charles. Charles working on Howard. Back outside it goes. They'll go around the horn again. And Charles, soft touch, can't get it to go. Rebound taken by Thomas, up and in. Ball on the floor momentarily. Quick hands, very alert for Thomas. Biggest lead of the game for Bangkok. They lead by 10, 12 now for Thomas. So Singapore up against it now. Ferocious inside defense by Bangkok. 10 on the shot clock. Alexander looking for movement. There's the screen off the bat. Alexander and Howard will put it up in. See if that's a three. But Singapore having no luck getting the ball inside. That's a two, so back to an 8-point lead. Goldstein, left hand to Charles. Who else? Up in the air. And a traveling call against Charles. You can't believe it, but he did shuffle his feet. Delvin Goh will inbound it. Remember last game, Goh had four quick fouls, so it was really a non-factor. His job is to crash the boards and try somehow to negate that big advantage that Bangkok has around the rim. Rotated to Desmond O. Desmond O around the screen, goes inside, back outside. Alexander underneath. He's trapped and gets it back outside to Howard. Wong, hand in his face, can't get it off. Outlet pass over to Lamb. He will go to the basket on the reverse and put it in. Great recognition. Goldstein to Lamb, circling underneath from the opposite side. Another 10-point lead for Bangkok, getting it done. On the break, Desmond O looking for a screen. Howard now. Singapore in trouble with 1:27 to go. Losing the ball once again. Thomas picks it up. Off to Goldstein. Charles lurking around. Ball in the air. Picked up by Janicek. Lamb, cool as you please from the left side. No good. Desmond O picking up the loose ball. And a foul. See who that goes on. That will be on Goldstein. That will be the first foul on him. Check that. Will be two on Goldstein. And going to the bench is Desmond O. We have not seen Wu since he was knocked with the shoe when he was on the floor a little while ago. So Singapore a little bit short-handed. See if Wu comes back in. No. So Singapore's ball with 107. Trying to get it, the deficit down below double digits. Go to Howard. Howard, what'd he do? He traveled. So another turnover for Singapore, traveling at both ends. Fans not real happy with that call. So another timeout by Singapore, 59.6 to go. They trail 44-34 here at the OCBC Arena.
Yes, hello guys. You're gonna flex, bro, show.
from Goldstein over to Lamb on the reverse. Pretty as you please. So it's not that high tech is just pounding the ball downstairs. They're also getting it done on the break as well, as we just saw. Two Thailand guys conspiring in the open court to get that done for High Tech City. So, well, if you're Singapore, you got to figure out a way to attack the basket with a little bit more regularity. You cannot become a one-dimensional team where you're reduced to just shooting the ball time after time from outside. It will not work against a team like Bangkok. What the High Tech Bangkok City team has to avoid is getting Chris Charles in foul trouble. Remember, 19 points in the first half for Charles, and he's got to like the matchups that he's got down low. Remember, Howard is working on Thomas, so it's either Alexander or somebody else who Charles, remember, stands 7'1". Alexander about 6'6", although he's very athletic. No way can he match up with Chris Charles. In fact, Charles with 17 points, and here come Bangkok again. Off the dribble, Goldstein rotates it to Thomas downstairs. Working on go, here comes Howard to help out, and it's Howard's effort to get it done for Singapore. Alexander is stripped. So that's exactly what Singapore trying to do, attack the basket. The Singapore ball, last touch by Bangkok. Checking it in will be Wong. Rosales also back in the game too. He's got the ball. Working on him is Janusuk. Around the horn he goes. Off the dribble, finds some space inside. He rambles, but knocked away by Charles. Rosales comes away with it. Five on the shot clock. Shot put up by Wong is off the mark. And another rebound for Chris Charles. Wow. That's got him with six offensive boards so far to go with the 17 points. Bangkok spreading it out. They'll go for the last shot. Trying to get the lead up to 12. And the ball, who's got it? Last touch by Bangkok. So 3.1 to go. Singapore will have the ball. Alexander to inbound it. Checking into the game now will be number 13, Piapong Perone. For Bangkok, and checking out will be Lamb. They don't want him to get any unnecessary fouls. He doesn't have any yet, but not a bad call. So Singapore 3.1 to get it down to single digits. A game that the crowd has been kept out of the game. Lamb appears to be a little bit shaken up. Rosales off the dribble. And the lane can't get it to go. So 44-34, High Tech, the dominant team here in the first half. As we go to the dressing room, Slingers are going to have to talk it over. Bangkok has to be very, very happy with the proceedings of the previous 20 minutes. We'll be back for halftime action in a moment.
Is to be different. It's not easy to step out and do something that the next person is not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what make your own way stands for. Your way. Everybody's is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block, you might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be, but everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Leaning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small. Now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and competent in any arena. It's coming.
Make your own way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, not a follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, without youth. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man, just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life, you know. So I've been there before and I get it.
To be different. It's not easy to step out and do something that the next person is not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you try to, you know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what make your own way stands for. Your way. Everybody's is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block, you might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be, but everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Leaning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small. Now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and competent in any arena.
Make your own way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, not a follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, without you. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man, just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life, you know. So I've been there before and I get it.
So getting it done from outside, but look at this guy, Chris Charles, little bounce pass inside to Thomas, eating him up alive. Delvin Gove, no way he's going to be able to stay with Stephen Thomas. Wu getting the ball off to Rosales, around the screen he goes, and another three, and that was good enough for Singapore for a while, but too much Chris Charles and Stephen Thomas down low as we look at Alexander dealing down low, and the ball saved, but right into the path of the X-man who fills it up again. Alert play by Xavier Alexander. Outlet pass by Bangkok, and here he goes on his way. The little reverse, can't get that to fall. And Singapore off to the races, 3-on-2. Alexander keeping his balance up and in. The two of his 8 points or 9 points in the first half. Rosales, little catch and shoot action for Singapore. Rosales, remember, player of the week last week, and kick back outside, and again, catch and shoot action for Justin Howard. Now Bangkok, stop and pop downstairs, though, to Lamb, the follow by Charles. Way, way too much of that. Owning the lanes was Chris Charles in that first half. As we said, 6 offensive boards, off-balance shot by Wong. He hits his third three. But not enough. There is the takeaway by Lamb, turning his defender inside out. The cleanup by Charles, hustling down the court, finding the lane. The trailer fills it up for Bangkok. Downstairs again. No hesitation, but check it out. Inside comes Stephen Thomas. Opportunism. Thomas staying engaged with the play, back up and in. He had 12 in the first half to match Charles is 17. Alexander getting the ball to Howard, and again, Thomas not rotating on his man quick enough. Right about that time, Bangkok called a timeout. And look at this, the reverse, and Lamb for 9 points in the first half. So 44-34 in favor of Bangkok at the half. Singapore is going to have to figure out a way to negate Chris Charles. He only has 2 fouls. Remember last game, Charles fouled out. I wouldn't count on that happening again this time, as Bangkok seems to be a team possessed. Singapore 20 minutes to try and figure it out here at the OCBC Arena. Here's the interview with one of the players that we got with before the game.
Actually, with the addition of Xavier Alexander, I thought that our team became a more running team compared to last year. With local guys, Chingda stepping up, and Leon, the rookie, stepping up. I feel that this year we are in a better position to win the championship.
Obviously, the local boys, a big story of this year's successful team. Now, Bangkok has a great starting five, maybe the best starting five in the league, but you've been able to beat them 2 out of 3 times, including beating them at their own gym. What do the Slingers have to do tonight to defeat the defending champion?
I would say defense. Defense is the key. For the previous 2 games, we've been trying to stop their bigs, trying to stop Thomas and Charles. But for today, we try to stop both of them, as well as the guards, Tyler Lamb and Freddie Goldstein. Because Lamb have 30 points last game against us, so we'll try to stop him and stop the other people and try to win this game now.
44-34 in favor of Bangkok over the Singapore Slingers. We'll be back for second half action after the break. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. 44-34, your halftime score here at the OCBC Arena here in Singapore. Bangkok High Tech City taking it to the Slingers, and they've been doing it in the interior and in the transition game. Chris Charles leading the way with 17 points, 13 rebounds, 6 offensive boards. Bookend Stephen Thomas with 12 points, and 5 of 6 from shooting. By the way, Charles, 8 of 12 from shooting, so you add them up. Those two guys alone, 13 of 18 from the floor. More than Singapore can deal with, and that has been the difference in this game. So rebounding and the two bigs just wheeling and dealing at will downstairs. So Singapore is going to have to find a way to do something to counteract that. Rosales gets the ball off to Go. Go inside, has the ball knocked away. Inside, Alexander trying to find some room, gets the ball back, and 24-second violation, and no help for Alexander down low. Go got himself isolated once again on the baseline, managed to get the ball to Alexander, but surrounded by the trees, nowhere to go. Goldstein now with the ball on the right side. Oh, working on him. Ball on the floor, knocked away. Goldstein with a shot, no good. Delvin Go with the rebound, gets the ball off to Alexander. Off to the races are Singapore. Rosales, a little fallback jumper, has the ball partially blocked. Shot by Howard is off the mark. So one and out. Great job getting back on D by Bangkok. Now Tyler Lamb trying to whip past the ball to Chris Charles. Didn't know it was coming. Out of bounds it goes. Singapore will get the ball back. They trail by 10. Bangkok led by as many as 12. Alexander now, and you can see that last play, a little bit of frustration by the X-Man. Howard trying to get loose from Thomas. Inside it goes, a holding foul. Who's that gonna go on? So good idea for Singapore to attack the basket. I think that's gonna go on Lamb. And if it is Lamb, that'll be his first foul. So Rosales to inbound it for the Slingers. Gets the ball outside to Alexander. Back to Rosales. Throwing the screen is Alexander. Wide open look at the three. He's not going to go there. Howard, he will take the three and be short for that. My goodness. And a foul by Desmond O. Why would you foul there? So first turnover of the second half. Lamb to inbound it. Gets the ball off to Charles. Magnificent first half for him. And around the corner he goes. Howard right there to meet him. Back to the open cup court comes Singapore. Alexander off out. Got it in one. Oh, what an acceleration. First step by Xavier Alexander, finding his lane and breezing through it. Check it out. Going to the left hand. Off the glass, up and in. He will go to the line. Maybe that's the spark that the Slingers need. 8-point gain now at the 8:23 mark. Best looking offensive move all evening for the Singapore, and no doubt they are heeding the advice of the coaches. You've got to attack the basket. Cannot be reduced to being a jump shooting team. And in it goes, a 3-point play. 7-point lead now for High Tech Bangkok. Full court pressure. Charles with the ball. Go working on him. Switching over. Gets the ball over to Goldstein. Racing across the half court stripe. Down low. It goes. The ball out of bounds. And let's see. It will be Bangkok ball. Check it out again on the replay. There's the inlet pass and knocked away quite clearly. Howard touching it last. And rolling to the basket, back outside to number zero. That is Winnipeg. Long three is off the mark. Ball in the hands of Alexander, racing down the court. He's got O on the left-hand side, off the dribble. Switches side and has the ball picked off by Lamb. Now Lamb in the open court. To Goldstein for the easy two. Well, I don't know what O was thinking. Dangerous pass in the best of times and stepping in the lane and just taking it away. So back to a 9-point lead. Delvin Goh looking for movement. Has the ball inside the lane. Still looking. Has his shot blocked. Underneath and let's see what we have. Is that a foul? No, it's a possession arrow. Nice hustle, but look at this. Go, not fooling anybody there. Trying to go up with the shot and has it partially blocked. So the ball back in the hands of High Tech Bangkok. Wudapong will inbound it. Again, full court pressure. We look at that again. Heads up play by Howard, but to no avail. Possession arrow going the other way. Wudapong now. Working on Wong, gets a step on Wong, rotates to the basket, up and in with the left hand. Dazim Wudapong, oohs and ahs by the crowd on that as he turns the corner, gets the step on Wong. The lead now jacked up to 11. In the lane goes Alexander, can't hit the layup. Offensive board, shots off the mark. Back outside to Rosales. Going inside the lane and loses the ball to Charles. Outlet pass again. Lamb on the run to Goldstein for two. No. Offensive foul on Goldstein. A break for Singapore. as they are getting run out of their own gym. Another mistake by Delvin Goh, coughing the ball up. Now there is Lamb. Now here's Goldstein. Oh, there's the push by Lamb. You can see. So back comes Rosales, gives the ball off to Alexander, looking for some movement around the horn inside. They need to get it. Alexander, Lamb working on him. There's a mismatch, but Thomas stepping over. Down goes Lamb, up goes Alexander, and foul from behind. And that will go on Charles. That will be number three on Chris Charles. So a little deja vu. Remember last game, Charles fouling out of the game, Thomas reaching in, and there's the foul from behind. Been better off just to give Alexander the shot. So at the line is Alexander. See if they give Charles a third foul. Yes, they do, so it's official. So look for the Slingers to go straight at Chris Charles. He has been the one. He has been the difference maker tonight for Bangkok. Alexander at the line. Foul situation. In fact, Charles is really the only one in any sort of foul trouble at all. Bangkok in control of this game. If they can control their emotions, and really a very unnecessary foul, as we said before, for Charles. Just go ahead and let Alexander finish off the two-point shot, but certainly don't give up a foul. Your most important guy, who's already fouled out once in these meetings, and that taken off the rim and no goaltending called. Off the dribble, Goldstein with a wild shot, up and in. The floater in the lane. And Bangkok up by 13. Getting a step on his defender, straight down the court, A to B. Howard, Alexander, Howard will take the shot and drain it from Dewsville. So an 11-point lead now. Wild and woolly stuff here at the OCBC Center. Woodapong off the dribble. Again, losing Rosales. Gets it back outside to Goldstein. Thomas coming over and applying the screen. Finding a lane. The long three is jacked up. Howard with the rebound. Outlet to Wong. He'll wait for Guffey. No, he'll put up the three. Got it! 50-42. Singapore to within eight. Fourth tray of the game for Wong Wei Leong. And Bangkok calls a timeout. Well, wild and woolly stuff. We thought for sure that Wong would lead the break and pass it off. Instead, he takes a chance and drains his fourth triple of the game. He had Alexander ahead of him. So Singapore, who a minute ago were trailing by 13, back in it, trailing by 8, with 5:30 to go here in the third quarter. So things are slowly starting to flow Singapore's way if they can take care of the ball. And talking about taking care of the ball, Singapore with 8 first half turnovers, only 6 for Bangkok. You look at all the other statistics, rebounds, total 13 rebounds for Singapore, 21 rebounds for Bangkok. An amazing 7 offensive boards. Of course, 6 of those owned by Charles. He now suddenly is in foul trouble with 3, so they certainly don't want him to pick up a 4th foul before the 4th quarter. For Singapore's perspective, they will probably go straight at Chris Charles, who remains in the game. Now it'll be Bangkok ball again at the 5:30 mark. So finally some life in the Slingers. They have been very lethargic on offense, and Charles go working on him, gets the ball off to Goldstein. Rosales giving him a wide berth. Around the screen he goes. Lamb working at the top. Goldstein underneath the basket, gets the ball outside to Wadapong. Wadapong, 7 on the shot clock. Tyler Lambert, Goldstein from the corner, trying to get past Alexander. Alexander takes it away. Gets the ball ahead to Rosales. Rosales looking for Wong on the other side of the corner. He will get to the lane. The shot from the left side is good. Oh, yes. Wong with the hard hand. Another three. 50-45. Singapore back in the comeback trail. Charles. Howard working on him. Dumping the ball down to Thomas and a foul. Believe that'll be against Go for holding on. Here it is on the break. Rosales spotting up Wong and little catch and shoot, the fifth triple for Wong. And we talked about his ability, the streakiness that he possesses. Full exhibition tonight for Wong Wei Leong. What a Pong. Big overload on the right-hand side, getting around one defender and a foul. I believe that'll be on Wong. You can see the idea, trying to get around him to get it Delvin Go. So for Wong, foul number three on him, I think. So joining Charles, possible foul trouble. Oh, with three fouls. In fact, that is Wong's second foul. So off the break on the out-of-bounds play, Thomas with the ball. And sense of urgency now and losing it out of bounds. Lamb loses the ball. You can clearly see taking his eye off of it. A little bit of a meltdown here. Bangkok led by 13. Trimmed to five. 4:27 to go here in the third quarter. Rotation to Rosales. The long three is going to be off the mark. Thomas with the rebound. Long outlet pass broken up by Singapore. Last touch in the hands of Charles. Yes, and one. Chris Charles right there trailing the play right where he was supposed to be. Gets the errant pass, puts it right back up in the foul. That will go on Rosales. Check it out again. There's the save. Nice job by Lamb and right into the hands of Charles. Reached up and corralled the shot, put it in, and the foul on Rosales. Rosales, that's three fouls on him, and Charles can't complete the three-point play, but it's a seven-point lead now for Bangkok. Rosales barking signals, gets it out to Alexander, who's been quiet lately. Howard, still Howard, over in the corner to Rosales. Baseline, he goes. Charles doing a good job of sealing that off. Inside, Howard, soft touch, no good. Rosales picks it off from the elbow, no good. Rosales gets his own rebound, the reset now. 11 on the shot clock. Circling around is Wong. Wong getting past one defender and a touch foul. That will go on Goldstein. Fans appreciating the fight in Singapore, coming back from the 13-point deficit. A lot of work to do still, and that will put Wong at the line. A chance to trim it to five. Here at the OCBC Arena, Chuck Schreiner with you, hoping you're enjoying this game. Nice looking crowd here, a couple of days away from Chinese New Year. Gongxi Fai Chai from all this here to you and yours. Wong with the first one. Wong now 16 points. All of his points except the free throw coming from Trey's. 5 of 7 from downtown. Got the second one too, so 52-47. Charles getting around Go and gets rid of it finally. What a Pong. Pressure defense by Singapore. Off to Lamb. Lamb getting around Go. Stop jumper, no good. Here comes Alexander on the break. He's going to take it all the way to the house for two. And a foul. He will go to the line. Oh, my goodness. The X-Man. Here he is in the open court backing up his Woodapong. Never a good sign when your defender is backing up. Look at him. Should have made a commitment earlier. He gets him on the hands, and now Alexander at the line with a chance to pull the Slingers back to within two. 3:22 to go here in the third quarter. Going to be short. Rebound taken by Goldstein. Lamb, the reverse. Tipped in by who else? Chris Charles. So the lead back up to 5, 54-49. Go to Alexander. Howard down on the low post. Alexander attacking the rim. Gets isolated in the left-hand corner. The ball's on the floor. Picked up by Woodipong. Off to the races he go. One more man to beat. Up. Can't get it to go. Howard with the rebound. Outlet pass to go. Go. Couple of dribbles. Wide open. Look for. Woo! Yeah! Oh! Woo Chinde! 54-52. Singapore to within 2. Goldstein. Working against Juan Charles. Go in his face, rolling to the basket, off balance shot, and the foul will go on Go. That will send Chris Charles through the line. Savvy move by Chris Charles. So let's see how many that is on Go. That will be 3 on Go. Charles, despite the noise from the crowd, sends home the first one. Charles now 20, make it 21 points. Bangkok up by 4, 2:22 to go here in the third quarter. We got a good one here at the OCBC Arena. Rotation over to the right, Wu now around the screen of Delvin Go. Left-hand dribble now to Alexander, inside to Howard. Thomas working on him, waiting for cutters. Post-up move inside, the turn, the fire, no good. Off the hands of Go, outlet pass. Lead pass to Lamb. Lamb underneath, has the ball knocked away and a foul. And that will go on Howard, who was trailing the play. Nice job by Howard to get back, but he fouls, and he fouls hard. Check it out. There is Lamb. Ooh, boy. I believe the foul's on Wong, actually. So that will be 3 on Wong. And let's see what sort of a foul that is. Looked pretty rough. Let's see if that's going to be a flagrant. I believe that's going to be the case. Yes, so Lamb will go to the line. I think he'll shoot 2. And then Bangkok will get the ball. Wong will check out of the game. I think Desmond O will go back in. The crowd appreciates the effort by Wong, but a little bit reckless type of a foul there for Wong. So Lamb, a chance for it to get Bangkok back up again by 6. Misses the front end. 1:59 to go here in the third quarter. Chuck Schreiner with you. If you don't enjoy this game, I don't know what to say. 1 of 2. So the lead 5, and Bangkok will have the ball. Chance to get it up to 7 points. Whittapong to Thomas. Thomas rotating the ball to Goldstein. Rosales will work on him. Pass inside. Whittapong trying to turn the corner. Wild shot. Howard has it. Alexander on the break. Still Alexander to Rosales. The reverse. Yeah! Chris Rosales. Oh, what a shot by him. 57-54, a minute 34 to go. Nice job by Alexander to run the break. There's a shot by Rosales, just like they teach you on the playground. Charles now with the ball, being hassled. The ball back in the hands of Goldstein, easily getting it up the court. Rosales working on him. Here comes the screen. Howard, backup jumper is good. Nice shot by Goldstein. Count that as a 3, so a 5-point lead now for Bangkok. Tenacious on the offensive end. Little stop and pop action there. The rebound, foul behind by Howard. Try to bully Thomas out of the way. So for Howard, I believe that will be his 2nd foul. Howard with 12 points. There is the push from behind. 57.8 to go here in the third quarter, and what a fourth quarter we're in for. And that will send the other end. Thomas will go to the line for 2. Look at couple of the fans who have been pretty exuberant today over on the bench. Good job by Thomas. Gets the lead back up to six. So every time Singapore makes a run at Bangkok, Bangkok has the answer. Just to make it a seven-point game again. Howard with the rebound. Under a minute to go, Alexander will wait for numbers. Back outside to Howard. Rosales looking for separation. Go flashing across the middle. Rosales now running the baseline. Opposite side it goes. Rotates back outside to Alexander. Charles, Alexander, the fallback jumper, no good. Howard will pull down the board. Back outside to Rosales. 35 seconds to go. Alexander thinking about it, looking for the screen. He runs the baseline, turns, squirms, and he is fouled. And that'll send him to the line. Nice job by Alexander forcing the action in the interior, getting a step on his defender. So 28.8, check it out again. Wadapong turning him around. Nice little 180 move downstairs. Thomas coming over to supply the weak side help. And that's two on Wadapong. Missing the first of two is Xavier Alexander. Singapore got it as close as two. So trying to get it to within five and get a stop and come back in and maybe stuff one in at the close of the third quarter. The ball up in the air, back out to Alexander, who gets it home. Great job by Howard to tip it back out to the X-Man. Alertly stuffs it home. Ball taken away by Alexander on the floor. What do we have here? A foul, and that's going to go against Goldstein. Goldstein diving on the floor. The ball was loose. Alexander also went for it. I think Goldstein grabbed on. Let's watch it again. There's the ball on the floor. Now take your pick. They give the foul to Goldstein. I don't know. So a timeout on the court by Bangkok, 16.7. Singapore, a chance to get it to within two when we come back. Another look at it. They're clearly, and I guess they say Goldstein fouled Alexander. Could have gone either way. Goldstein poked. Protestations don't make any marks, so that'll put Alexander at the line. Goldstein now with how many fouls? With two fouls. Actually, with five fouls, excuse me. That is Goldstein's fifth foul, so shades of what happened in the last game. Now, Charles only with three. So Singapore hoping to make this one, get a stop, and perhaps come back and get a closing bucket at the end of the third quarter. Bangkok playing for the first shot. There it is, 60-57 for Bangkok, 16.7 to do something with it. With the ball now, number 12, Lockin. Lockin to Charles. Charles, double team, looking for somebody to get the ball to. 6 seconds to go, a little pull-up jumper, it's good! Oh, wow! What a shot by Lockman. The shot at the buzzer, no good. 62-57, high-tech Bangkok City, 5-point lead. We'll be back for fourth quarter action in a moment.
Oh!
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Getting ready for the final 10 minutes of this very exciting contest between the Singapore Slingers and the high-tech Bangkok City. 62-57 in favor of the visitors, and they've done that with relentless rebounding behind a magical game by Chris Charles. 21 points, 14 rebounds, 6 offensive boards. He's had help. Singapore, who trailed by 10 at the half, down by 5 now with the ball. Delvin Goh with the ball. Wu back into the game. Alexander, what a game he has had for Singapore. He's got 13. Howard, the one-handed shot off the mark. Rebound taken by number 12. That is Lockhon. Lockhon stolen away by Howard. Thomas coming back. He loses the ball inside. Trailing the play was Alexander, who picks it up and dumps it in. 3-point lead now. Thomas bringing the ball down. Charles lurking on the low post. Rosales working on him. Ball off the mark, followed by Charles. Lead pass by Howard is over mark, overshooting the mark, and Alexander. Ball falling out of bounds. So an unnecessary turnover for Singapore. Bangkok will have the ball back on the near sidelines. In fact, on the baseline now, since it occurred on the break. Lamb outside. Thomas. Alexander working on him. Forces the shot way off the mark. Howard is there. The ball on the floor. Picked up by Charles. Inside the ball goes and off the mark. Picked up by Waterfong. Some sloppy stuff by both these teams. Waterfong dribbling. Getting to the basket. Knocked away. Go picks it up. Rosales has Wu on the left-hand side. Rosales still turns. Glass. Up and in. 64-61. Rosales on the break. The trap. Charles with the ball. Working on go. Picks up the dribble. Now the ball in the hands of Lamb. Lamb turning the corner. Stops. Gets the ball back out to number 12. That's Lockin. Underneath the goes. Let's see who's got it. It'll be Bangkok ball. Wong checking back into the game. Rosales coming out. He looks like he's limping. And that could be significant. Rosales, one of the better guards, point guards in the league. Turning and firing is Thomas for two. At the 8-11 mark, at the 24-second buzzer. What poise by Thomas. Alexander. What a war we have here at the OCBC Arena. Alexander off the dribble. Howard to Wong. Wong sheds one defender. Looking for spacing. Fires up the three. 66-64. The 6-3 of the game for Wong. Thomas go in his back pocket. Loses the ball momentarily. Picked up by Lockman. Lockman downstairs to Charles, overcomes Alexander, the reverse is good. Great recognition. Getting the ball to Waterpong. The lead back up to 4, bounce pass over to Wu on the left side. Howard looking for cutters, back outside to go. Singapore spreading out the offense, around the screen goes Wu. Wu working against Thomas, trying to get separation, forces the ball, last touch by Bangkok. 4 left on the shot clock. Wu trying to force the issue there, and Singapore 4 seconds in which to do something with the ball. Off the inbound, Howard grabs it on the floor, picked up by Bangkok. Shot over to Alexander, but the 24-second clock expires, and a turnover at the 7:01 mark. Bangkok will come away with it. Goldstein on the bench with 4 fouls. That's got to hurt Bangkok. Charles hanging tough. Only 3. Remember, he fouled out last game. And so far, Bangkok hanging in. What do you say about Wong Wei Long? 20 points, 6 trays. Lockman off the feed by Thomas. Now Thomas with it again. Charles trying to get some spacing, throws the screen. Lockman off the dribble, fires, got it. Great job on the interior by Charles to throw the screen. Alexander and a foul, and that will go on Lamb. That'll be three on Lamb. Great acceleration there by Alexander. 110% by all these players. What a game Alexander has had. Alexander with 13 points, six assists. Wu, wide open look, is going to be off the mark, way off the mark, right into the path of Charles. So Wu, the hero of the three games before the last game, and Lamb rolls through the basket, out of bounds it goes. Last touch by Howard. Bangkok will have the ball. 16 left on the shot clock, and Bangkok attacking the basket, getting ready to check back into the game again. Rosales, Wu will go out. You're saying Wu could not miss a shot a couple games ago. Last two games, you wonder where it's gone, and such is the life of the jump shooter. Thomas now, go working on him. Couple of dribbles, pulls it up off the mark. Howard with the rebound. Outlet pass to Rosales. Two on two. Stutter step in the lane. The turn around he goes. And yeah, Chris Rosales on the 180. Oh, look at this. Now what do we have? The ball kicked away. It'll be Bangkok ball. Alexander hustling. Look at this again. Now watch Rosales off the dribble. Turning Lamb inside out. So 4-point game, 70-66, 6 minutes to go. Charles, around go. Lockman, he hit the last jumper. Wong working on him, Rosales now. Post up move by Wanchon, and out of bounds it goes. Last touch by Singapore. Eight left on the shot clock. Dasam Wadapong. Nice interior defense again by Singapore. Both these teams not giving an inch on the interior. Points inside, hard to come by. Charles thought about taking it. Dumps it in instead. The turn and shot by Wadapong is good. 72-66. Wong. Alexander on the left-hand side. Rosales perched on the right. He's got the ball. Howard will stop and pop. Off the mark it goes. Charles with yet another rebound. Bangkok again dodging the bullet. Lockman now on the right-hand side. Rosales inside it goes. Knocked away. Picked up by Lamb. Heads up play by Lamb. Lamb looking for separation off the dribble. 1 foot and shot no good. Rebound taken by Lockman again. He's had a good game, Lockman. Coming in for Goldstein. They don't lose a whole lot there, and a foul will go on Wong. Wong playing it a little bit too close, too aggressive. Lockman will inbound it from the far side. 4:57 to go here in the fourth quarter. Chuck Schreiner with you. I know you've got to be enjoying this. League-leading Singapore Slingers in the second place. High-tech Bangkok City defending champions. And another loss by Bangkok would be devastating for their league title hopes. That would put them at 5 losses with 4 games to play. Singapore would run up to 14-2. So doing everything in their power to stop that reality. Lockman will check it in into Charles. Go working on him. Again, Wadapong off the dribble. He goes a long three. Yeah! Oh, my goodness. 75-66. And Bangkok leads by 9. Singapore will call a timeout. The local boys coming through. First Lockman to check this shot out under pressure by Dasam Wadapong. The backup jumper. Nothing but net on the timeout. Bangkok up by 9. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. 75-66, High Tech over the Slingers with 4:47 to go. Singapore's 11-point winning streak hanging in the air right now. And what a shot by Dasim Wadapong. You don't want to call it the dagger, but if the game doesn't turn out Singapore's way, they will look back to that shot for sure. High Tech have come into enemy territory and wrestled the game away from Singapore thus far. A lot of time to go still, but High Tech playing like a desperate team, and it is paying off for them. High point man in the game is Chris Charles with 23. And that doesn't even begin to tell the story, the job he's done on the boards. Also, Thomas and Wadapong and company thwarting Singapore at every turn. The screen there, Rosales rises and fires, no good. The rebound underneath taken by Charles. Who else? Again, time on Bangkok's side now is Wadapong yo-yoing the ball outside and immediately throws it away. Didn't need that. I don't know what Wadapong was thinking about. The lock-in, excuse me, throwing behind Stephen Thomas. So Slinger's ball on the near sidelines and a new lease on life, 4:20 to go. Need to fill the ball up and get back and get some stops. Rosales gets the ball off to Wu. Wu now to Alexander, looking to attack the basket. Turns, looking for any sort of space at all, and Charles is too much for him. Back come Bangkok. Lockman again rotates the ball to Wadapong underneath the Charles, all alone. Easy two on the flush. 77-66. Bangkok in control by 11, under 4 minutes to go. Alexander rotates the ball to the left. Wu way off the mark, right into the hands of Howard, who loses it. Picked up by who else? Charles. He has been everywhere. Thomas. Build up now on the right side. Alexander trying to watch Charles underneath. Turning the corner is Loftman. Inside it goes. Post up move. Wadapong and a traveling call. So Singapore will get the ball back. Situation now in the game. Singapore has to score about every trip down the court. And they've got to get stops. Rosales, Wu, has his pocket pick, land the other way, and that could be the dagger right there. 3:11 mark, 79-66. Bangkok matching their biggest lead of the game. Timeout by Singapore here at the OCBC Arena. Replay with Lam stealing the ball and up and in, as pretty as you please. Singapore not taking care of the ball. Singapore with 11 turnovers, and same as Bangkok, but that is number 12, and it couldn't have come at a worse time for the Slingers. We're looking more and more like a team that is not going to win this game here on their own home court, and you gotta dip your hat to High Tech Bangkok City. Chris Charles, 25 points. They held their collective breath when he picked up his third foul. You sort of got the feeling that, well, this could be happening again, but no, not this time. Another game, another day, and Chris Charles has done it all. Thomas with 15 points. So that's 40 points out of the 79 have come from those two guys alone. But don't forget the contributions of Dasim Wadapong. A huge, huge three. He's got 14. Also, Lam in double figures with 13 for the Bangkok. The other side of the ball, Wong with 20. Rosales with 14. Alexander with 15. And Howard with 12. But not enough. Singapore unable to stop the onslaught. Bangkok, not just a matter, as we said before, of pounding the ball downstairs. They are also very effective on the break and taking advantage of every turnover by Singapore, taking it up and in. So Singapore backs against the wall now. Rosales over to Alexander. Wu now checking back into the game. They could use some contributions from him. The ball knocked away and almost saved by Thomas. So Bangkok will have the ball back. We check that. Singapore will have the ball back. Check it out again. There is the denial by Thomas, who comes over right by our booth, in fact. So Wong to check it in. Rosales off the turnaround. Got it for the three. Well, that's a start. In fact, they're going to give him only two there. 79-68. The lead trimmed to 11. Thomas getting the ball off to Lofman. And ball almost taken away again. And what do we have here? They're going to say a foul on Bangkok. So Singapore will get the ball at the 244 mark. Watch it again. Silly pass there. Alexander wide awake getting it. Then have the ball now. Rosales in the lane. Somehow gets it to go. Great hesitation move. Defender goes past him, and Chris Rosales gets it to go. And the other end, two. And a chance to make it a three-point play for Lamb. Well, that has been the story of Bangkok all evening. Every time Singapore starts to encroach on the lead, a big play back the other way. Check it out on the outlet pass. Desmond Oh with the foul. Great control in the air by Lamb and a chance to make it a three-point play. 11-point lead now for Bangkok. Checking into the game, Desmond Oh for Singapore. There it up. Howard corralling the rebound. Urgency now by Singapore and knocked away. Checking into the game is Quick. Winnipeg says, get it out of here. So last touch. Good job by Quick to attack the basket. But Winnipeg more than equal to the task. Ball up in the air, knocked away. Last touch by Thomas. So it'll be Singapore ball. Singapore will have the ball in their backcourt. Quick will check it into Rosales. 220 to do something about this 11-point lead of Bangkok. Step up three is going to be off the mark. Thomas pulls down the rebound. Outlet pass to Woodapong at the other end, and a foul, and that'll go on Rosales, and that'll be number four on him. So Singapore having to protect the ball on the inbounds, trying for the turnover, and Bangkok running a man down in center field, and the outlet pass finds him. Singapore having to foul, so 2:10 to go. The ball will be checked in. What a game Woodapong has had. For Bangkok, the ball out of bounds. Last touch by Singapore. Howard coming over. So should Singapore lose this game, they would fall to 13-3, and Bangkok would climb to 12-4, and that would put them exactly one game behind Singapore. Stepping on the line, that shot is no good. Lamb. So Singapore will get the ball back. Remember, Singapore, two of their final four games on the road against the Mono Vampires. No easy task for them. Alexander at the 2 minute mark. Pull up jumper is going to be off the mark and tipped around. Thomas staying with it. Charles picks it up again. And a foul by Howard. So 151. And unless something untoward happens, Bangkok's going to walk out of the OCBC arena with their heads held high. And new life in chasing down their Liga, or defending their league championship that they won last year. Full court pressure by Singapore. Lamb breaks that in the hands of Charles. He takes matters in his own hand, gets it past the half court line. Back outside to the accelerating Lamb, who loses it. Singapore will have the ball. Quick will check it in. So Lamb a little bit out of control there on that possession. No need to do that. Really, all Bangkok needs to do is run the time down whenever they have a possession. Singapore, the team under pressure. Lamb not playing like that on the last possession. Here comes Rosales. Rosales around the screen, first towards the basket, wide open, look for Quick on the right side, misses everything. Thomas pulls down the board. Lundman with the ball now. passes the ball off to Charles. Charles and Alexander getting into it. No foul, and finally Alexander does foul, and it occurs at the 1:19 mark. So Singapore not giving in until the bitter end, but the foul starting to mount up, and that'll send who else? Charles to the line. What a game he has had. 25 points, 14 rebounds, 7 offensive boards, 3 steals, 2 blocks. The only thing he hasn't done is worked at the concession stand tonight. So Chris Charles finding a nice home here in Singapore at the OCBC Arena. Definitely the man of the game thus far. A reed-like stick of a guy, but my goodness, what skills he possesses. Immaculate footwork he's got. Very impressive last time he was here at the OCBC Arena as well. I believe the defending most valuable player in this league, and where would they be without him? You put him together with number 15, Steve Thomas, and that's a formidable pair down low. I don't care who you're playing. Add to that Lamb, Wadapong, and Fred Goldstein, and probably the most talented starting five in the league. Around the screen, Wong looking for separation. Trying to work on Lawman and loses the ball in a backcourt violation, and Bangkok will take it over at the 1:09 mark, and things going from bad to worse for Singapore. They trail 82-70. The security has to tell one of the fans to go sit down. Singapore fan, Lamb off the dribble, Rosales working on him. 17 seconds in which to operate, and now playing much smarter off the dribble. Kicks it back outside again. Lawman on the long three is going to be off the mark. Off the dribble comes Alexander. Lamb coming over and applying the foul. Silly foul by Lamb, 49.1, and that puts Alexander at the line for a pair. But Bangkok is going to win this game, and Singapore being held to 70-something points. Bangkok, remember, narrowly lost to the Slingers 3 weeks ago, 83-80. You might want to circle this date on your calendar if you're a high-tech Bangkok City fan, and when the resurrection started, and perhaps they start their charge in earnest towards defending their championship that they won in the 2014-2015 season. Alexander missing the front end of two and nails the second one, 82-71. Let's see what we have here. A timeout being called by Bangkok. You want to make sure that they don't make any silly mistakes in the last 49 seconds. So 82-71 on the timeout. Nice looking shot of the crowd here that came out here hoping for Singapore to bury the hopes of high-tech Bangkok City. Instead, it was the group from Bangkok that have breathed fire into their title hopes here at the OCBC Arena. They lead 82-71 with 49.1 to go here. Chuck Schreiner with you. Hoping you're enjoying this game. And it was very, very close throughout then. The fourth quarter, which normally belongs to Singapore, went the other way as high-tech took advantage of a couple blunders by Singapore on their possessions and continued to get the ball down low where they could do their damage. Thomas with 15 and this Charles with 25, but it's been a cast of many. Wittepong, Alexander working on him. A long three is going to be off the mark. Rebound pulled down by Wong. Outlet pass to Alexander. Alexander attacking the rim up and in. So 82-73, and Singapore still playing defense, and a foul on Rosales. And for Rosales, I believe that will be five on him, so that will be it. Chris Rosales following up his Player of the Week effort last time on Sunday against Saigon, where he had 20 points with 16 points tonight, but that will be it for him. Checking into the game will be Desmond O, 25.9 to go, Bangkok at the line. What a team effort for this high-tech city team. As we said, it's been not just the two bigs, but what a game for Dasom Wodapong, pouring in 14 points, Lam with 15. Goldstein with six. How about the shot by Bandit Lookon when they needed it, when Singapore was making that concerted charge at them? They led by only two, and Lockham knocks down a three to get the margin back up to five, and really Singapore never recovered after that. Ball out of bounds there off of somebody's foot. So 22.3 to go, 10-point lead. Now, in Bangkok's favor, they have three of their last four games at home. Look at this, and there is Chris Chaw sticking his foot up. Singapore is going to have a couple games at home and a couple games away. They've got to play the Mono Vampires, and they're slicing through the lane as Alexander, 83-75 with 15 to go, and this will probably be the last possession. Charles with the ball. 9 seconds to go. Wu chasing him down. There's the pass to Wodapong. Out of bounds it goes, and Bangkok will have it. And they're going to walk out here, as we said, with their heads held high. They thoroughly outplayed Singapore, and they deserve this win. And finally, somebody puts a number on Singapore. And they do it with a shutdown defense of their own, but Chris Charles, he doesn't get Player of the Week for this effort. I don't know. Wodapong, last second shot is off the mark, and that will do it. The heave by Alexander at the whistle, and high-tech Bangkok City does it. They defeat the Slingers 83-75 before a nice crowd who give both these teams a nice round of applause. And you can certainly see these two teams getting it together in the finals in March. So it wasn't to be. Singapore going after their 13th straight win, falls short. Their side of the ball, Howard with 12, Alexander with 20, Wong with 20, and Rosales with 16. But the Chris Charles and Stephen Thomas story, making life tough for Singapore down low. They out-rebound Singapore by 8, and Charles also with 7 offensive rebounds. We look at the revamped standings. That is after the game here. Slingers fall to 13-3, and look at it, a logjam in second place. High Tech City and Westport Dragons, something's got to give. High Tech plays the Dragons in two games, but they've got to go to Bangkok to play that. So we'll have to hold our breath and see Saigon, Mono Vampires. Singapore has a date with them for two games, and that will bring an end here to the OCBC Arena. By the way, on February the 14th, that's Valentine's Day. Let's see if it'll be lucky for the Slingers as they take on Westport Malaysia, who, sort of like Bangkok, needs a win to stay relevant in this race. So final score again, High Tech Bangkok City defeats Singapore at the OCBC Arena, 83-75. For the production crew here, this is Chuck Schreiner. We'll see you next time.
things in life is to be different. It's not easy to step out and do something that the next person is not doing.
You know, I grew up as a kid, you know, looking at the NBA, dreaming hopefully one day I can get there. I grew up watching All-Star games and, you know, thinking that'd be cool, you know, if I can make it there. And now I'm 11 years in consecutively, so you try not to take it for granted. You know, you try to, you know, you understand that nothing is guaranteed to you. So I'm thankful.
Don't be afraid to be different, man. That's what Make Your Own Way stands for. Your way. Everybody's is different. Everybody got a different story. You might be from the same block. You might be from the same park, the same neighborhood, whatever the case may be, but everybody got a different path.
I think what Dwayne and Li Ning are doing for these kids is unbelievable, man. I think we need more of those type of people that are not afraid to sacrifice something that's cool for something that can have a positive effect on so many others, and most importantly, a younger generation.
D-Wade coming to my high school, it means the greatest thing in the world, basically. And he's giving back to me, like this room, before he gave back to this room, it was really small. Now it just looks excellent, it looks the best. And D-Wade coming to my school, personally, that's just the greatest thing to ever happen, because most people, when they make it, they don't come back.
What these kids get to learn in these moments is not just how to put a ball in a hoop. They learn how to be themselves, be confident and competent in any arena. They're coming.
Make Your Own Way to me is kind of like paving your own path to greatness.
Be a leader, kind of follower.
To inspire other people to lead by example.
Challenging my team to find the need in the community, you know, with that youth. And, you know, going around and trying to, you know, figure it out, man. And, you know, we always try to leave an impact. You know, every time we come to a city, I know how important that is. You know, it can be something small, man. Just by seeing someone come to your school or see someone care about you enough, it can change your whole outlook on life. You know, so I've been there before and I get it.